They're identical.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Whiskey Dictionary. Today, I want to talk to you about Weller Special Reserve. Now, this is not a bottle I've reviewed on the channel before, because frankly, it's very hard to get. And that's something I kind of want to talk about for a minute. So if you're just here looking for a review, nosing, tasting, my overall opinion, go ahead and check the timestamps below, and you can get right to that spot. But if you're interested in a rant, you're about to hear it. So a couple weeks ago, I was over in Wegmans, which is my local grocery store, and I was buying the PX Cask Strength Laphroaig. And I had that in my hand, and I just went up to the guy that was working there, and I said, hey, you know what, do you have any allocated bottles in the back that you'd be willing to let me know about? Which I thought is about the friendliest way of asking that question. You know, you showing that you're buying something, you're asking if they'd be willing to even let you know about a thing, not just, hey, what do you got in the back? So if you're ever looking, I think that's an okay way to ask. Anyway. So I asked, and he said, well, we actually just got some Weller in this morning. I was like, really? That's surprising. And so he said, well, you have some Special Reserve and the 107. I said, well, I've already reviewed the 107. I don't want to be greedy. So how about just the Special Reserve? And he hands me a bottle. I said, how much is this going to cost me? I figured it'd be like $50, some like minor amount of gouging. Wegmans is big enough. I didn't think they'd go crazy. He said it'd be $35, which is $11 over MSRP. So I was like, wow. Okay. Yeah, sure. I'll take that. No problem. Brought it home, drank some of it, and we're going to talk about that today. But I do want to talk a little bit about just what is going on with the prices of Buffalo Trace products. Many of us will be familiar with the price gouging that's going on with the full Weller line, both in the secondary market, which is a little bit expected, but also in the primary market. Less than a month ago, I was in a store that had this bottle on the shelf for $125. And you know what I did? I walked out of that store. I didn't buy a single thing from there. They had what I needed, actually. And I walked out because screw that, right? So let's just talk for a sec. Why did this all happen? And I've done a little bit of research into this because it's not just, oh, Pappy. So let's, you know, buy some other stuff from the same distillery that makes Pappy. That's part of it. But more so, there's this, you know, I call it a hype train that is Reddit, Instagram, and Twitter. And these are things that kind of feed upon themselves, right? Let's say you go to the store and you get yourself a Weller Full Proof and a Weller Special Reserve, and you post a picture. Hey guys, I scored. I got these Weller bottles. You're going to get like a dozen comments of people supporting you. It's not people saying like, ah, you idiot. You know, why'd you buy that? It's holy crap. That's amazing. Where'd you get that? Did they have any more left on the shelf? It's this constant stream and cycle of positive feedback, right? Positive feedback loop. But here's the problem. There's a lot of fools out there with way too much money who are buying these things at higher prices than they ever should. And that, along with Buffalo Trace creating a bit of a, artificial demand, is not helping. So when you have Pappy Van Winkle, which I can see why that's a premium product. It should never, ever, ever fetch the prices that it's currently fetching. But the MSRP of a couple hundred dollars for, you know, a 23 Pappy makes sense to me because it's 23 years old. Somebody had to store it for that amount of time. But when you're talking about Weller, which, I mean, this is about a 4 to 7 aged thing. It doesn't even have an age statement on it. So, you know, you could think closer to 4, especially now where they're trying to pump this stuff up. Guarantee you this is closer to 4. You're not paying anything. Like that's just cost of business for them. They can sell this bottle at $18. So anyway, back to the Reddit thing. You're getting all this dopamine from people who are telling you that you're good, telling you that you're awesome and that you got a score, that it is now creating something that feeds upon itself and the prices are going to go up and secondary people are going to go buy those bottles specifically for people who want to pay a little extra to get that in their collection. It's feeding upon itself. And you see it in almost any hobby that you've got. I also collect video games, or at least I used to, and I was really deep into that. And some of the games that are very expensive make absolutely no sense for any NES collectors out there, like Stadium Events, right? It goes for $15,000. It's a terrible game. It doesn't make any sense. And there's plenty of them out there. So anyway, I digress. Back to the whiskey. I'm really frustrated by the inability to find like any Buffalo Trace products. And I mean, I'm lucky. I have Eagle Rare. I have a Blanton's Gold. I have several others. And it's just, I have the regular Buffalo Trace. It's just other people can't get this. And that sucks. Because when I think about new people coming into whiskey, I would happily recommend anything from Buffalo Trace as a starter bourbon if they were not stupid prices. And, you know, I've got this platform. I occasionally like to use it for a soapbox. So thank you for listening to my rant. But don't support these idiots. Don't buy stuff on secondary market if you can help it. You know, I get it. Some of us really want it and fine, whatever. But you're just making the problem worse. Don't let these fools get away with this stuff. All right, let's talk about Weller. Weller Special Reserve is 45% ABV, so at least it's not 40%. It's got no age statement, but commonly believed to be between 4 and 7 years. It is a 70% corn, 16% wheat, 14% malted barley mash bill, at least theorized. It's not confirmed by Buffalo Trace, but that's basically it. People know. It is chill filtered, and its MSRP, again, is about $24. All right, so let's ignore everything about price for a minute, and let's just think about what's in the glass, because frankly, you might be able to get this for a reasonable price. So let's see if it's worth your money. Keeping in mind that this is about a $24 whiskey, I'm going to set my expectations pretty low and see what we've got. The nose on here is actually not bad at all. It's pretty pleasant. It's not too astringent considering 90% ABV. That'd be a whole different monster. 45% ABV, 90 proof. So when I smell this, there's no alcohol burn. This has a pretty considerable amount of vanilla to it and butterscotch. It's got kind of a faint hint of apples, cherries, vanilla for sure. This is just classic bourbon notes to a pretty good degree. Now, I will say those cherries are pretty muted, so you might not find those immediately, but keep at it. You know, even consider smelling some cherries or even some like maraschino cherries and then see what you think here if you're looking to actually improve your nosing. Yeah, I think that's about it, but I really wouldn't expect a whole heck of a lot more. All right, let's go ahead and give this a taste. Cheers. Now, here's my problem, at least for right now. This is pretty thin. I find this surprisingly thin for 90%. There is a little bit, like, it rounds out a little bit in the finish. Let me just take another sip here. I have some opinions, but I want to make sure they're as valid as they could be. Yeah. So when I'm drinking a bourbon, one of the things I personally like to taste in it is oak. I find that oak kind of gives this base layer of flavor for everything else to build off of. There is virtually no oak in this, and I get that's my personal preference, but that's what we're here for. I find the lack of oak here to make the whole thing feel watery and thinner than it should. But what I am tasting here actually is that ABV is kind of coming across more than it did in the nose, to the point where it's actually covering up a lot of the flavors. So that's not great. And I will kind of get to this in a minute. When I was drinking this, obviously, I've had quite a bit. I've added water previously, and that does help a little bit. But then it's already tasting a little thin and watery. So when you add a little bit of water, it helps with the alcohol, doesn't help with the taste. So keep that in mind. This could be a good starter one if you can get it for a reasonable price. All right, let me try one more time and give you some actual notes here. Cinnamon, cinnamon, red apples, I guess a little bit of vanilla, very light on the vanilla, which would be explained by the lack of the oak here. There's not a whole lot going on, actually. I feel like I want to give you something more. Did I say caramel? Yeah, it's interesting. The nose is way more impressive than the taste here. For me, the taste is just so thin. It's disappointing, but it's also a little bit in line with the price point. This is something that I would actually, if I were just a casual drinker, I'd probably put over some rocks and I'd be fine with it. I wouldn't even notice that it was thin. I'd just be like, oh, it must be watered down. So, all right, let's go ahead and just kind of give you an overall here. I've had a lot to say about Weller, and I'm going to try to put some of this to the side. Again, concentrating on what's in the bottle, because that's actually what's important here. Is this something I would recommend that you have? In my mind, no. And here's why. First off, there's a couple of good alternatives that I'll give you recommendations for in a minute. I think that this bottle is not worth the $24. And I find that surprising to say, but, well, how do I want to say this? first off, I don't think that you're going to find this for $24. So the idea of seeking this out just to see what it's like is fine, is whatever. But I said I was going to put that to the side, so let me do that. The flavor on this for me is what ruins it for me. It is just weak and it's thin. And it's just not what I would want in a bourbon, especially when I know that there's better options out there for about the same price. So let me present these couple different options and then let you know. So oddly enough, Bernheim from Heaven Hill, this is a 7-year bourbon. It's about the same price and maybe a little bit more, like we're talking within $5 or so. And this is considerably better than this. This has that oak, you know, layer that kind of helps to be built upon. It doesn't taste nearly as thin. Makes a great cocktail. It's actually a good chunk of this was put into cocktails. But ultimately, I think that this is a better option than this. Weller has nothing but its name in my mind. And I do really, really like Buffalo Trace products. The other thing that I would recommend is Maker's 46. Now, this is a bottle that you can get for about $30 to $32. Way better than both of these options, actually. If you want to buy anything, like I'm keeping this strictly to weeded whiskeys. If you want to buy anything, I would suggest buying that Maker's 46. Try that. Let me know what you think about it. But my suggestion here is just ignore this. If you want to try it for the, you know, prestige or whatever you want to consider the experience of having Weller, then go ahead and try it. You know, see if you can get it at a bar. But you're probably going to overpay. You're probably going to, you know, it's kind of lackluster. Get something more interesting. You know, that's really all I can say is this one does not live up to the hype. There are some Wellers that do, but this one does not. All right, let's see what you guys thought. I asked a slightly different question on the poll this week, and I said, if you had this bottle available to you for $35 and you planned on drinking it, what would you rate it? And 11% said to stock it, 27% said to buy it, 17% said to try it, 11% said to ignore it, and 35% of people had never had it. Now, these results were shocking to me because I just kind of assumed less people had ever had this bottle. I mean, I know I can't even find it up here, so I was surprised, and that's one of the best ratios that we've ever had. Seems like people are going out of their way to have this. Now, obviously, I'm in that 11%, but that doesn't mean that you have to be. So what I would like you to consider is if you can't find this and you want to try something really good, go get that Maker's 46 or the Bernheim, but Maker's 46 would definitely be my recommendation. So I want to say thank you to all of my patrons who helped me to buy these bottles and do these reviews and keep the channel going. Thank you very much. If you are interested in helping out to support, check the description below. And if you want to learn more about the Antique Weller 107, check this video over here. Or if you want to learn about the Maker's 46, check it out over here. And I hope you all have a great rest of your day. Cheers. How did that happen?